high school in the summertime, I worked at one of those seafood shacks in New Hampshire, where at the end of the day I smelled like a fried clam and a lobster roll. It was awful. My first dream job, however, was in college. And it doesn't actually sound like a dream job, but I'll explain why. I worked at a tanning salon. It was my college dream job because I got paid to do my homework, I was tan all year round, and I didn't have to work nights and weekends, so I still got to experience college the way that I wanted to. That's why it was my dream job, not because of the content. My advice for somebody who wants to pursue their dream job is don't be afraid. The regular jobs of today will always be there. You can't be afraid to take a leap and try to get your dream job. If you don't try, you'll never get it. It's a guarantee. So I think success is unique to every single person. How I would define success for me is being able to wake up every day and knowing that whatever I want to do that day, I can do. It's my choice, and I'm living for myself and for my family, not for anybody else. I think if I was going to switch places with somebody right now, it wouldn't be necessarily for a different job, but more so for an adventure. I'd want to change places with a person who's about to board a plane for a trip around the world. I've had the opportunity to live in all sorts of different places, and I know that there's a lot more culture and experience out there that I'd love to see, so that's who I'd change places with. So I'm a sailor, and at sea you see a lot of wild and crazy things, but the wildest, probably, that I've seen in my years of sailing is on the north side of the Dominican Republic, on an overnight sail, beautiful night, calm, peaceful night. I'm at the helm alone, my husband's asleep, getting some shut-eye, and I'm watching the radar, and there's a blip, and there's a boat that seems to be following us, yet there's no lights and no sound. So I freak out a little bit, wake up my husband, try to figure out what to do, and within seconds, we hear engines fire up, and I don't know, maybe 10, 15 seconds later, there's a 70-foot Navy cutter alongside of us, in the middle of the ocean, in the middle of the Dominican Republic. It's insane. We worked through it, they hailed us on the radio, but it was definitely wild and crazy, but I'm happy I'm still here and it wasn't pirates. This is Dream Jobbing with Rachel Ottaviano. Change your story.